We have a video here on rational equations and functions. This kind of works off the last few videos that we've been working on. You need those skills in order to do this video. And so therefore we're going to go ahead and get started. Sometimes you're going to have problems that look like this. Let's say one fraction is equal to another fraction. And so what's the value of y going to be here? Well, if we think about it, since we have an equal sign and we just have one fraction on the left and one fraction on the right, we can just cross multiply and solve it out. So let's go ahead and do that. Cross multiply 5 times 3 will give you 15. And that's going to be equal to y plus 2 multiplied by y. Now let's go ahead and distribute here. Y times y is y squared. Y times 2 is positive 2y. And let's go ahead and subtract 15 from both sides, and we know that there is nothing to subtract 15 from on the right side because there are no like terms over there. And so this is what we have left. Now, since this is set equal to 0, we can split it up into two parentheses. There are two numbers that multiply to get negative 15 that add up to get positive 2. Those two numbers are going to be 5 and 3 in some combination. It's a positive 2, so the 5 has to be positive and the 3 will be negative. So we say positive 5, negative 3. And work this out. Set each one of these parentheses equal to 0. So y is equal to negative 5 and y is equal to 3. Not finished though. We're not finished. You see what this says at the very top? Check for extraneous solution. Extraneous solutions would be what value can I plug in there for y to make that equal to 0? Because you cannot have 0 on the bottom of, you can't have 0 on the bottom of the fraction. So y plus 2 is equal to 0, and y would be equal to negative 2. But really, we cannot have y to be negative 2. And look at our answers down here at the very bottom. Negative 5, that's not negative 2. And 3, that is not negative 2. If either one of those would have been negative 2, we would have had to say that it couldn't be a solution. So in this case, we have our two solutions, negative 5 and positive 3. And don't forget, if there was a variable over here on the bottom of this fraction, you would have to figure out what that variable could not be also. But in this case, we just had a 3 down there. Here's the problem. It's solved exactly the same way. Let me see you go ahead and try and work this out, and then check your solution with mine at the end. We're going to say we have 2 times x plus 1, and we have negative 4x times x minus 2. Distribute 2x, positive 2. Distribute negative 4x squared and positive 8x. Negative 4 times negative 2 was positive 8x. Now let's get everything to one side. So I want to add 4x squared and I want to subtract 8x from this side, leaving us with 0. And we're going to add 4x squared. There's no like terms with it. And we subtract 8x from 2x. So we have 4x squared, 2x minus 8x is negative 6x, and a positive 2. I'm looking, I know 2 goes into every single one of them, so I'm factoring out that, leaving 2x squared minus 3x plus 1. 2x squared minus 3x plus 1, and that's equal to 0. What values? Just think that we're going to cross off, divide both sides by 2, and it crosses off. So let's go ahead and make our little chart here. The values that multiply to get 2, that add up to get negative 3. I think it's negative 2 and negative 1. Adds up to get negative 3. And so now let's split this up. Let's see, we have 2x squared minus 3x plus 1 is going to split up into 2x squared, and then these up here, minus 2x minus 1x plus 1. On the left one, you can factor out 2x, leaving you with x minus 1. And on the right one, you factor out negative 1, leaving you with x minus 1. So therefore, what we're left with down here, when we factor, we have 2x minus 1. And these ones, x minus 1. And that's equal to 0. 0 over 2 is 0. So therefore, x in this case is equal to 1, and x in this case is equal to 1 half. Don't forget to check for extraneous solutions. So let's go ahead and do that. Our extraneous solutions, 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, and 1 minus 1 is negative 1. Neither one of those are 0, so that's good. Let's plug the other one, 1 half. 1 half plus 1 is 3 halves, which isn't 0. And then here, 1 half minus 2 is negative 3 halves, which is not 0. So therefore, these are our solutions. You could have up here, you could have said x cannot equal what? Negative 1, and x cannot equal 2, because if it was negative 1 or 2, then the bottom of those fractions would be 0, not allowed, and neither one of these are negative 1 or 2. So either you can figure out what would make 0 on the bottom, or you can take your solutions and plug them in and see that they don't make 0 on the bottom. All right, this problem here. This one's a little bit different. You can't cross multiply and divide here. You can't do this because we have an addition sign in between there. So, with the addition sign, that does something a little bit different. We have to somehow combine these two fractions and then set them equal to this and then cross multiply and divide, or I think I'm going to show you a different method. So let's look at a common denominator between x, 3, and x. So there's our three denominators. What's the common denominator? The common denominator. All right, so in 2 over x, think about this as the bottom of the fraction. There you go. There's your x from there. Now, here we have to have the 3 in the bottom, so I'm putting that in front of the x. And now let's look at this one. This one already has it in there once, so we don't need to put it in there again. So our common denominator is going to be 3x. That's our common denominator. So we have 2 over x times something is equal to something over 3x. Well, what do you, and let's go 1 over 3 times something is equal to something over 3x. And then the last fraction, 4 over x times something is equal to something over 3x. So what do we have to do here? Well, we know that we have to multiply x by 3 to get 3x. So therefore, we have to multiply the top number by 3. And we get 6 on top. 1 over 3, we know we have to multiply the 3 by x to get 3x, so therefore we have to multiply the top by x. So 1 times x is x. Multiply straight across. And on the bottom, we know we have to multiply the bottom by 3 to get 3x, and therefore multiply the top by 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So now we have 3 new fractions here, and they all have a common denominator. We have 6 over 3x plus x over 3x, and that's equal to 12 over 3x. Combine these two fractions, since they have common denominators of 3x. We know that when we combine them, 3x will be the common denominator, or is the denominator. And then what is 6 plus x? 6 plus x. And that must be equal to 12 over 3x. Now, once you have this set up this way and the denominators are the same, you can almost forget about the denominators. You can almost just eliminate them from the problem. Well, I'm going to show you once why you can eliminate them from the problem. You're trying to get 6 plus x by itself, so we multiply it by 3x on both sides. And when we multiply by 3x, those 3x's cancel each other out, leaving us with 6 plus x. Now, if we multiplied by 3x on the left side, we have to multiply by 3x on the right side. And then if we look, the 3x's cancel each other out, and we're left with 12. So from this point forward, I'm just going to, when we get to common denominators like that, I'm just going to forget about the denominators and just only solve the top. You notice how we have 6x, 6x, and we have a 12 and a 12. The top has not changed. Top's still the same, it's just we've multiplied both sides by 3x, and that eliminates the denominator. Now, how do we solve this? Subtract x, or I'm sorry, subtract 6 from both sides, leaving us with x is equal to 6. Check for extraneous solutions. Up here at the top, can x equal 6 there? Yes, because 6 is not 0, and the same thing there. It can equal 6 because the bottom of the fraction would not be 0. So there's your answer. X is equal to 6. See if you can go ahead and try this one on your own. If you feel confident enough to do that, then go ahead and try it and then check your solution with mine. If you need to go step by step and pause the video and check to make sure that each step you're doing is correct, then that's fine too. It's very similar to the last example though. A common denominator is going to be, let's see on the bottom, we need a 6, we need a d, and that 6 is already there, so we don't need to put it in. Common denominator is 6d. First fraction, d over 6 multiplied by what is equal to 6 over d. Second fraction, 15 over d And the third fraction, 5 over 6. And here we're just creating equivalent fractions. So let's go ahead and get that done. What do you have to multiply this 6 by to get 6d? Well, you have to multiply it by d. Multiply the top by d then. D times d is d squared. What do you have to multiply that d by to get 6d? You have to multiply it by 6. So therefore, you have to multiply the top number by 6, and 15 times 6 is going to be 90. And then on the very last fraction, what do you have to multiply the 6 by to get 6d? You have to multiply it by d. And 5 times d is d. I'm sorry, 5 times d is 5d. Let's go ahead and line our three fractions up. We have d squared over top of 6d plus 90 over 6d is equal to 5d over 6d. You notice they all have 6d for denominators. You want to get rid of them. And you're left with d squared plus 90 is equal to 5d. And since you see d squared, you should be thinking that you should be able to factor this at some point. So let's make it equal to 0. Let's set the equation equal to 0. So we have d squared minus 5d because it does not have a like term. And you have a positive 90. That's equal to 0 because those cancel each other out. Two numbers that multiply to give you 90 that add up to give you negative 5. Let's go through some of these numbers. Well, if we look here, 6 and 15. If they have to add up to give you a negative, both of them have to be negative, and therefore this is negative 21. It's not negative 5. Negative 9, negative 10 is negative 19. Negative 5 and 18 makes negative 23. Let's look at negative 2 and negative 45 is negative 47. Negative 1 and negative 90 is negative 91. Let's see. And negative 3, negative 30 is negative 33. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 doesn't go into it evenly. We have 5 and 6. 7 does not go into it evenly. 8 doesn't go into it evenly. And 9 does go into it. So we got 9 and then 10 and so forth. Well, we have all the factors. None of them multiply to get 90 and add up to get negative 5. So therefore, this one here is all the further that you can go at this present moment. You're probably going to be using things like the quadratic formula or graphing to find the solutions for this. So at this point, this is all the further you can go. It's all the further you can go. So let's move on to the next slide then. This one here, you now we have not just one term down there at the bottom. We actually have a binomial here and a binomial there. And then here you're multiplying two binomials. The one here on the this one, if you see x minus 2 and x plus 2, you may have it may have been written like this, x squared minus 4. And you should know that this is a difference of perfect squares. And you should factor it down into this real quick. But anyways, it's already factored down, so that's what we like. We need to find a common denominator. Common denominator, let's put x plus 2 there. Or that's a minus 2. X minus 2 into the denominator. We have to put this one. X plus 2 has to go in there. Now let's look at both of these factors here. First off, x minus 2. We already have x minus 2 in the denominator. And x plus 2. We already have x plus 2 in the denominator. So we don't need to pull anything from this fraction down into our common denominator. We can just leave it the way we have it. Okay, so that's our common denominator. 1 over x minus 2. And our common denominator, x minus 2, x plus 2. Second fraction, 1 over x plus 2. And our common denominator, x minus 2, x plus 2. And the third one, we don't need to, the third one's not going to change because the common denominator is already the same as the denominator in the third fraction. So we're good to go there. Now, what do we have to multiply x minus 2 by to get the common denominator? Well, we see x minus 2 in the common denominator. That right there is what you have to multiply x minus 2 by. X plus 2. And remember, it's supposed to be a fraction. So what is 1 times x plus 2? X plus 2. And now let's look here. X plus 2. In the second fraction and in the common denominator, x plus 2. What did we multiply x plus 2 by to get the common denominator? That would have been an x minus 2. So multiply that by both the top and the bottom. So 1 times x minus 2, pretty simple. X minus 2. And so let's go ahead and do some combining. We know it's a plus sign, so let's take these two things and add them together. X plus 2 plus x minus 2. Now there's a plus sign in between those parentheses, so we really don't need those parentheses since we're adding. If there was a subtraction, remember we would have to distribute the negative 1 to everything into the second parentheses, but it's adding, so we're good to go. Combine like terms. X plus x is 2x, and 2 plus negative 2 is 0. So we don't need to put that there. But we do still have our common denominator on the bottom. Right, so that's the left side of the equal sign. We haven't dealt with the right side yet because I'm going to erase some things. I'm going to erase all of this stuff here above that line. So if you need it, pause the video. If not, I'm erasing it. And I'm also erasing this other part here on the right. So this is the left side. And now on the right side, we have equals 4 over x minus 2 and x plus 2. They have the same denominator, so we're going to cross them out. And we're left with 2x equals 4. Solving for x x equals 2. So this says check for extraneous solutions. So let's take our value. Right here, we know x cannot equal. If we set this equal to 0, x cannot equal 2. And we set this one equal to 0, x cannot equal negative 2. But if we look at our answer has 2 in it. And what's this say right here? X cannot equal 2. So this is not a solution. So therefore, there are no solutions. There are no solutions to solve that. Moving right along. This one here. Let's go ahead and work it out, solve it out. We have to find a common denominator first. Common denominator has to have everything in it possible, so let's go ahead and figure out what the common denominator is. X plus 4. X plus 4 has to go into it. X has to also go into it, and I'm going to stick that X out front. And now let's look at X squared plus 4. Is X squared plus 4, can we factor it? Well, we know X squared is a perfect square. 4 is a perfect square, but that plus sign is not a subtraction sign. If it was a subtraction sign, we could go x plus 2, x minus 2, but it's not. So we have to leave it like that. And you might wonder, and you might say, well, x squared plus 4, isn't that x and x plus 4? Because we pull this x out of this x. Well, no, that's not the case, because remember, if you distribute, you're going to get x squared plus 4x, and the 4 does not have an x with it. So you have to recognize that this x squared plus 4 has to go into there, because x plus 4 is different than x squared plus 4. And so now, since we have all those terms in there, our denominator is going to be fairly large here. So we're going to need some room to work. So why don't you go ahead and make sure you have enough room there on your paper. So here's our denominator. I'm going to do these one at a time here. I'm going to do these one at a time. So we have 3 over x plus 4 multiplied by something to get this denominator. Well, there's x plus 4, and look at the denominator, x plus 4. What have I not underlined in the denominator? I have not underlined an x, and I have not underlined x squared plus 4. So that's what we have to multiply the first fraction by. X and x squared plus 4, we have to multiply it by everything that's in the denominator. So x and x squared plus 4. Let's clean this up a little bit. What's x times x squared? That's x cubed. And x times 4 is 4x. And now the 3 times all of that, 3x cubed plus 4x. X cubed plus 4x. Now, let me move that out of the way. You have more room on your paper, so you can just move on down. I don't have a whole lot of room here on the screen. I'm running out of room, actually. So let me erase some things. I'm erasing this work here on the left, if you need that. Pause the video. Let's look at the second fraction. The second fraction is 4 over x. What do we have to multiply it by? Well, let's look at the denominator. We have x in the denominator, and we have x in the denominator. What do we not have underlined? X plus 4, x squared, x squared plus 4. That's what we don't have underlined. And so when we don't have it underlined, those are the things that we have to multiply the fraction by. Let's go ahead and do that on top. And so now, let's go ahead and multiply. 4 times all of that. First off, here's what we have. We have x plus 4 and x squared plus 4. What is x times x squared? X cubed. X times 4 plus 4x. 4 times x squared is positive 4x squared. And 4 times 6, or 4 times 4 is positive 16. When I rewrite it up there, I'm going to switch those two. That way, my exponents are in order from least to greatest. So we have x cubed plus 4x squared plus 4x plus 16. And now instead of multiplying 4 by all of that, we have to multiply 4 by those values since we multiplied those two parentheses. What's 4 times x cubed? 4x cubed. 4 times 4x squared, 16x squared. 4 times 4x is 16x. And 4 times 16 is 64. Let me go ahead and move this up to the top. And now let's look at our last fraction. Our last fraction is negative 5 over top of x squared plus 4. What did we multiply that by to get the common denominator? Well, there's x squared plus 4, and look in the denominator, the common denominator, x squared plus 4. So what have we not underlined? We have not underlined the x and the x plus 4. So that's what you have to multiply both the top and the bottom by, x and x plus 4. So when we go ahead and do this, x times x is x squared, and x times 4 is positive 4x. And so 5 times all of that, we get 5x squared plus 20x. Five x squared plus 20x. All right. And I think I may have made a mistake on the first one. It's not that big of a mistake. You can fix it pretty easily. Let me check it before I go on. There's the first fraction, and we have to multiply it by denominators. So x plus 4 is in the denominator. So we have to multiply it by x and x squared plus 4. Go ahead and multiply those. We should get x cubed plus 4x, x cubed plus 4x. And now when we multiply this 3 by everything, and I forgot to multiply it by everything. So if we look up here at the very top of the screen, Let me bring it back. When you take that 3 and multiply it by x cubed, you get 3x cubed, but when you take it and multiply it by 4x, you should get 12x. Yes. All right. So that's what we have. Okay, now we need to bring everything down together. There's our first fraction. Here's going to be our second fraction. There's a plus sign in between them. And we have the equal sign. And our third fraction. It's right there. Since they all have common denominators, we're going to not look at the denominators. We're going to look at what they have on top. So let's combine some things. 3x cubed will get added with 4x cubed to make 7x cubed. There's the positive 16x squared. And 12x gets combined with 16x to make 28x. And then we have a positive 64. All of that is equal to 5x squared plus 20x. Now our whole goal is to try and set this equal to 0 so we can solve for x. So let's subtract 5x squared. And that will give us 11x squared, and that's a positive 11x squared. And let's subtract 20x. And subtract 20x because those are like terms, and that leaves us with a positive 8x. And drop everything else down. Okay, we know if we look there's not a number that goes into 7, 11, 8, or 64. There's not one number that goes in all four of those. And we know that x does not go into all four of them because 64 does not have an x with it. So we need to try and factor by grouping and see if this will help. 7x cubed plus 11x squared, you can pull x squared out of it, and that leaves you with 7x plus 11. And the one on the right, 8x plus 64, you can pull a positive 8 out, and that leaves you with x plus 8. We know that those are not the same. Those are not the same in the parentheses, so therefore, this is all we can do. We have simplified this down. You'll probably use a different method. You could use graphing to solve this. You guys could do that right now. If you had a graphing calculator, you could type it in there. But how to solve these out are coming in the future, in a future lesson. So this is all the further that you can go at this point. Let's move on to the next slide. All right, let's come up with common denominator. First off, you see this trinomial here, you should be thinking two numbers that multiply to give you negative 12 that add up to give you positive 1. That would be r plus 4 R minus 3. Our common denominator is going to be R minus 3 from here. We know this has a 1 underneath it. It's 1 over 1. We don't really need the invisible 1 out front. And let's look at this. There's R minus 3 that's already in the common denominator, but R plus 4 needs to go there. R plus 4. All right, so let's look at this. Try and figure it out. What do you have to multiply this fraction by to get the common denominator? The only thing you have to multiply it by is R plus 4. So R plus 4 and the common denominator, R plus 4. If we look there, there's the common denominator. So let's take this negative 4 and distribute it. Negative 4R plus negative 16. So I'm going to put minus 16. All right, now we have a plus sign, so we're going to put a plus sign. What do you have to multiply 1 over 1 by to get the common I'm sorry, the common denominator? Well, both of these actually you have to multiply it by 1, because if we're going to have r plus 3 on the bottom, or I'm sorry, r minus 3. R minus 3 from here. If you're going to have R minus 3 on the bottom and R plus 4 on the bottom, you have to multiply the top by the same things. R minus 3, R plus 4. And what happens when you multiply R minus 3 and R plus 4? Well, we factored this out, right? So therefore, when you multiply those, that's what you should get. So I'm going to put that on there. R squared plus R minus 12. If you notice, I'm not separating each fraction up anymore. I'm just combining things right now on the top of the fraction bar. Here's the equal sign. And now, remember, this is already r minus 3 and r plus 4. And we don't have to multiply the denominator by anything to get the common denominator. You see how both of those factors are already in the common denominator? So we just go ahead and take negative 10, since we don't have to multiply it by anything, and write it down there all by itself. And instead of having the common denominator written underneath every single thing, I've just made one big fraction bar and put it all underneath one big fraction bar, because really, if they all have the common denominator, don't we just cross it off anyways? And so now let's combine like terms. We have r squared. We have negative 4r plus r, which is negative 3r. Negative 16 minus 12 is negative 28. That's equal to negative 10. And let's add 10 to both sides. And so now we get r squared minus 3r minus 18 is equal to 0. And that's why we added 10 to both sides, because we had to set it equal to 0 to solve this out. Now, two numbers that multiply to give you negative 18 that add up to give you negative 3. Negative 18 to add up to give negative 3. I'm thinking it's 6 and 3. Negative 6. Positive 3, we'll do that. And so now our factors are x. We had negative 6, and we had a positive 3. It's equal to 0. How do we solve each one of these? We know that r is equal to a positive 6 in the left parentheses, and r is equal to a negative 3 in the right parentheses. So there's our two solutions. Now we need to check for extraneous solutions. Let's check for extraneous solutions. Let's see, we had r minus 3 and r plus 4. Well, r cannot equal negative 4, r cannot equal 3, and the same thing here. R cannot equal 3. And so the numbers it cannot equal, 3 and negative 4, which is neither one of the answers that we have. So therefore, r is equal to 6, r is equal to negative 3. And the last one here, you can try this one on your own, or you can work through it with me. But try this one on your own and or check the solution when you're finished. You see the trinomial on the right? Let's go ahead and see if we can factor it up. Two numbers that multiply to get negative 24 that add up to get 2. I believe it's negative 6 and positive 4. There you go. So we have now factored c squared minus 2c minus 24 into c minus 6 and c plus 4. Common denominator, c plus 4 from the first fraction goes into the common denominator. The 1, we don't need to put the 1 there. And so if we look at the right fraction, the third fraction, we already have c plus 4 in the common denominator, so now we need to put a c minus 6 there. C minus 6. So let's start at the first parentheses. What do you have to multiply c plus 4 by to get the common denominator? Well, it already has c plus 4 in it, so you have to multiply it by the other factor of c minus 6. C minus 6. And if you multiply the bottom by c minus 6, you have to multiply the top by c minus 6. And when we do that, 8 times c and 8 times negative 6 is 8c minus 48. Okay, now let's look at the second fraction, which is 1. So we have 1 over 1. What do we have to multiply 1 by in the denominator to get the common denominator? Well, we have to multiply by everything, both the c plus 4 and the c minus 6. So when we go ahead and multiply it by c plus 4 and c minus 6, we have to multiply the top by c plus 4 and c minus 6. So on top, what is 1 times those fractions? Well, if we think about it, those fractions were right here, weren't they? When we multiply those together, we should get that blue line that I have crossed off. C plus 4 times c minus 6, c plus 4 times c minus 6 is right there. Remember, we added, so I'm putting the plus sign, it's c squared minus 2c minus 24. And if that would have been a subtraction problem, you remember you have to put it in parentheses because that negative 1 has to get distributed to everything inside. And what's that equal to? Let's look at the third fraction here. You notice what's in the denominator of the third fraction is in the denominator of the common denominator. So therefore, 5c doesn't get multiplied by anything because the denominator did not get multiplied by anything. And now since they all have a common denominator, we can cross it off. In this case, I'm erasing it so that way we have more room to work. So we have to combine like terms, set equal to zero, and factor. Combining like terms, there's the only c squared. 8c minus 2c is 6c. And you, The other thing we have left is negative 48 and negative 24. Negative 48 minus 24 should give you negative 72, and that's equal to 5c. Now let's set it equal to 0 by subtracting 5c from both sides. C squared plus 6c minus 5c is going to be 1c, and we have a negative 72. What are two numbers that multiply to give you negative 72 that add up to give you a 1? Add up to give you a 1. Well, I know it's 8 and 9. Now, which one's got to be the positive and which one has to be negative? Well, if the 1 has to be positive, the larger number has to be positive, so therefore 8 is the negative value. And we split this into c minus 8, c plus 9, and that's equal to 0. C in the left parentheses will equal 8. C in the right parentheses will equal negative 9. Are they allowed to equal 8 and negative 9? Come up here to the top. C cannot equal, set that equal to 0. C cannot equal negative 4. Right here, C cannot equal 6. And once again, this other one, c cannot equal negative 4 there. So the only two solutions that we cannot have are negative 4 and positive 6. And if we look down here at our solutions, we do not have either one of those. So therefore, 8 and negative 9 are the solutions to this equation that we have. So. That's all we have for this video. If you have any questions, let me know and we'll get those figured out for you.